He's good. He's good.
I'm going to struggle against him.
We played him in ZVT just a little while ago. And he beat me. Enough is enough. If I can just straight up hold off his first attack, though, I'll be better off. That's what I struggled with last time. Enough is enough. We require more
minerals. What the fuck?
Coming in after proxying four racks, right? Kappa. Save that money. Yeah, I think I'll go for six links. Gonna pull off a gas. I'm just gonna get the Roach one a little bit quicker than the last game. You think he'll do the same thing? I doubt it. He probably has a couple builds. I know I do. Even in single matchups, and I play random, so. He made it himself here. That's a full nade, pretty much, unfortunately. Not gonna lose any Zerglings, though. Good micro, but did this SCV just clutch this? No. Here's the answer. The answer is a hard no. I think I just killed the Reaper as well. So this game's already starting off way better for me. Than the previous one, by the way. We're in position to see. Another couple freebies. This is a very good start for me. Put a little bit of damage on this. He might try the same thing, but this time it's just not gonna go as well. It looks like he is. That he did last time, that is. He's gonna come across. He's gonna have Hellbat soon enough. Can I get my queens through? Oh god, that could have been so bad. Yeah, he's going for it. Are those the bats on the base yet? No, not yet. Definitely much better off, though. I'm actually just gonna add these on here. It's still a strong attack, right? Like, Oh, come on. You gotta do better than that. You got the creep out. If I'd gotten that medevac, I'm in a great spot, but I did not get the medevac. So, He's just now Eddie on production. Honestly, I think a Nidus is still a great option. I was thinking about a Nidus before. And that's the only way I can really get in a position to deal with the Banshees as well. That makes sense. Because early on, I'm not going to be able to do anything against him with Roaches, because he just doesn't... I just don't have anti-air, right? So... When I played against this guy the last time, I failed because I couldn't... I'm going to wait to try to Nidus because he'll probably see it. I can Nidus in several different locations here, but... back in. Get inside, please. Also gonna have an attack from the front as well. I didn't kill all the Banshees, unfortunately. At least I got the tank. Is this really going to be a planetary? Is it going to be there in time? I think I get it. It's a big deal, by the way. On top of these tanks. Just trying to get more going on here. I think we're good to go, pretty much. Like, I think I've killed enough SCVs at this point that it's been worth it. You know what? No. I'm gonna get bro move. I get plus two. He's gonna have a lot of tanks. He has a decent chunk of Widow Mines, so it's time to make Roaches now. I think I got him this time. Oh, little bit of friendly fire, nothing too intense, but I think just having a solid three bases is already putting me in a nice spot. And we got the burrow move on the way. Make sure I have the Evo Chambers. He's trying too hard to micro now. I'm gonna have the burrow move in a sec. No, we're not, because I forgot to build it. JK, bro. That's unfortunate. Well, on the bright side, forcing out a scan here. Oh, I lost a lot of drones for no real reason. I think if I had burrow move, I'd be in such a great spot right now. I mean, it's not the end of the world, but it's annoying as shit now. Can we get a Nidus Worm in as well? Oh yeah, I still have some roaches in the Nidus. I just realized that. Let's see what's up here. GG. Not this time. Oh, we took it back. You're not getting me twice in a row. Not with the same build, especially. But yeah, I was kind of salty that last game. He beat me. Alright, let's go over that build. Now, we're going into this. Remember the last time I played against him, which was a few games ago. To refresh your memory, I got my Roach Warren late, and he did critical damage with a Hellbat timing that I couldn't really respond to. So I took a lot of damage, and then I was stuck in a position where I had to all in, and he defended. He did the same build to me this game, so I had that in mind when I was doing my build. Alright, so starting out against Terran. Hatch Burst is very common. It's a good fallback in anything. The biggest vulnerability is Proxy Raxus. If you don't Drone Scout, you're vulnerable. Like, if he had gone for a 4x proxy, I probably would have died, but it's a big risk, because if I scout it, then I don't die. But past that point, I'm getting my gas, and then the pool, right afterwards. I'm going to go for Zergling Speed as quickly as possible. This is one to deal with any early Reapers, or just deflect them. If he's going for a lot of Reapers, it's for defense. If it's going for less Reapers, if it's only one Reaper, then I get out of there. But having speed is your basic early defense or offense. So that is why I'm going to gas. You'll notice here, I make my next overlord at 19. 19 is your number. But yeah, as soon as I have 100 gas, I'm pulling 2 off of gas. And that's because I don't want any more... I'm not intending on getting any more gas-based things in the near future. I don't want roach, like, ravagers. I don't really... I mean, I would love to have them, but it's less important than having more minerals to be able to get my third base and to be able to get a good drone count and be able to get extra queens. So that's why I'm pulling off of gas. Alright, I see the Reaper. I do a little bit of micro. This isn't part of the build, but I usually make 6 lings. Now, this means you don't just keep pressing the D button. I actually stopped making drones for a little bit before the pool finished, so I would have a little bit of larva saved up to be able to deal with the Reaper. And that's how I can keep it from getting any drone kills. Now, I get in, and this overlord, my first overlord, is going towards... his main base. So what I do, I click on this gas gather. This is very important. Notice he has only mined 70 gas. 1936. You start at 2000. So I click on this. I know that is not his first gas gather. Why? Because I also see a factory and the fact he has a Reaper. That's 150 gas right there. That literally could not be his first gas gather. So I already know at this point he's got 2 gases and he's probably going to go for a heavy pressure, which leads me to believe he's going to be doing that Hellbat build he did in the previous game against me. So I'm already thinking about that. I see that he has 2 gases and no third command center, which is usually built here. It's not always, but it's usually built right here because you can just fly it down. So I'm thinking right now, okay, make sure my Roach Warren is on time. Try to get a third base up, but don't commit to the third base. Like, I'm not trying to make enough drones to saturate it, but if I can defend, and continue building queens. And you see right now, I'm already adding on 2 more queens after my first 2 queens immediately. I'm not taking a break. I get my injects, and now I'm going... I actually hotkey my queen. Well, I will in a second, I'm sure. I killed the Reaper. That was lucky. I was microing a little bit on the other side. That's unimportant. I moved the Overlord a little to get some more information. So I see here, there's no tech lab on the barracks. He's producing, but there's no tech lab. We got a reactor factory, which is 98% of the time Hellions, and a starport on the way with 2 gases. So, what this means is it's probably going to be Hellbats. There's a chance it could be, like, going into Liberators or something. But, I see the reactor on the factory, and I know it's going to be Hellions at the very least. The follow-up is kind of up in the air, but the fact he has 2 gases gives away that he wants to do a heavy pressure. So that is why I focus less on getting my third base fully droned, and more on getting my Roach Warren in a timely manner. There's the Roach Warren right after the third. The third is kind of a placeholder. It's somewhere like if I defend any early pressures, I've got a third. If he really puts on a lot of pressure, then I lose it, but I don't lose any drones. So now I come in. Now this is big. This is the big scout. I come in and I scout. There's nothing on that starport. So the only options are Medivac, Viking, or Liberator. The 2 gas gives away it's not going to be a Viking. You don't go 2 gas, no third command center into a Viking. That's already out. He's going heavy Hellion. So it could be a Medivac or a Liberator. I've already played against him, so I'm thinking of Medivac. But either way, I get Spore Crawlers, and I'm making Roaches, and I already know he's putting on the pressure. And now I seal the deal. I know what his add-ons look like. Yeah, he doesn't have a tech lab on his barracks, too. That's also important to note. And I see the armory. There you go. It's Hellbats. I'm making Roaches. I'm making Queens. And pretty much I stopped droning up until I defend this. I actually droned a little bit hard. I don't have that many more workers, but you just need to deflect this because I'm going to have 3 hatcheries. I do lose the third hatchery. But that third hatchery, I knew it was a risk. The important part is knowing when to cut your losses. Like if I defend... If I bring these queens out and these roaches out and I'm trying to defend this, like, all out, I will lose them. I don't have enough units. So instead, I say, all right, fuck that third hatch. You don't have a third command center. Fuck that third hatchery. I'm just doing whatever I can to make him focus on the hatchery and not focus on my units. Because behind this, pretty soon you'll see me droning again. Because I know even if I lose the third hatch, I've deflected any potential other economic damage. And... I can remake that third hatch instantly. Like, at this point, there's no way he's going to... There are 9 more drones in the production tab. And I also have vision, if you look at my vision here, of his third command center. So I know... Alright, I'm taking a third hatch at the same time. I'm making drones. I already have a layer up. I lost the third, but I took no damage otherwise. So I'm in an okay spot. And I also see that he has the tech lab on the starport, which means anything else is going to be delayed. And he's probably going towards mech, because usually nowadays, if you're going for Banshees, it leads into mech. It's hard to transition into bio meaningfully because you get overrun by a lot of timings. At this point, the build is pretty much over. The build was, I want to get up to three bases, I want to have a Roach Warren, and I want to have a lair, and I want to decide what direction I go based on scouting information. At this point, it's no longer a build, but it's a reaction to what he's doing and deciding the best possible option. So I see he's going for a third command center. He doesn't have many production facilities, and he's going for Hellions and Banshees. So I decide a Nidus is the best option because I have anti-air, and I have good anti-ground with the Roaches. If I go just for a Roach attack, he has Banshees, and I can't kill them. He'll eventually stop it. If I go for a Nidus, I can directly counter the Banshees, and I can make use of all these queens I made. So that was the decision-making going into the Nidus worm. So past this, you guys saw what happened. Any questions on any decisions I make up to, like, the 6-minute mark? Because past that, it's no longer really a build. It's just the style I like to play, or I want to play in this situation. That wasn't depth. That was not nearly depth. If you want me to go into depth, I will go another 12 minutes about this game. But that's the basic, from basics to more detail in scouting. I do win this game. You guys weren't watching? I started the replay like 6 minutes ago. I won the game, and then I went into this. But if you have any questions about the decision making before this point, I'm going to give you guys like a minute and then we'll go into another game. That was that. It became a pretty crazy game, but that was me. That was me explaining my opener, at least. What's the point of having more than two queens? Queens are the best unit Zerg has. I was going to say early on, but I'm going to say it right now. Queens are the best Zerg unit. They only cost minerals. They can heal. They can do damage to ground and air, and they're tanky. And they don't cost larva. Queens are amazing. In ZVT early on, getting more queens is for creep spread. It's for basic defense against things like Liberators, Banshees, and Medivacs. And it's for transfuse to support all your other units. Queens are amazing. When in doubt, this is my motto. In most matchups, but especially in ZVT. When in doubt, you don't know what they're doing, more queens. It counters everything in any matchup. It almost never hurts.